Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You have probably seen countless loan officers talk about a 2-1 buy down, how it lowers your rate, 2% in the first year, 1% in the second year, all that. But I don't know if it's ever been fully, thoroughly explained. Not going to take a long time to do this. You can always rewind the video if you miss something, okay? So make sure to rewind if you need to. I'm going to make this short and sweet. This is an actual deal that I closed. It's a 2-1 buy down. So yes, you can do these things you see lenders posting about. Yes, they do make it extremely affordable in the short term on those programs. And then, the whole reason you're doing this is the hope for an opportunity to refi in the future. We can't guarantee these people this. We don't know actually what's gonna ever happen. That of course means everything, their credit score, job, all the other reasons you have to qualify, not just your interest rate. So keep that in mind. But everything, going great, your ideal timing would be let the 2 years go by, use up the time you have on the buy down. When the opportunity comes up, you refi. Okay, we all understand that. If you need to hear it again, rewind it again. We've all heard that a million times. But this is how it works. So, for example, this particular client here, they did an FHA loan. Their rate was a 7.125. Rates are a little better today. I'm just talking about something that we already did. Their rate was a 7.125, and we asked for a seller credit of X amount. Now, to do a 2-1 buy down, you can't just make up an arbitrary number, okay? You have to put all the numbers for that transaction in there, and then you go in there and set up the 2-1 buy down, and it'll let you know what you need to collect from the seller so that all these numbers will work out. In this particular scenario, the purchase price on the house was $246. Okay, so they did a 2-1 buy down, interest rate 7.125. So for this person to have a equivalent to a 6.125 the first year and a 5.125 the second year, we needed to collect from the seller $5,661.96. Okay. Now, do you have to get down to the penny on that? Not really. But you don't want to ask for less. Okay. So you could just say $5,700 if you wanted to. That remainder would just go to regular closing costs. Okay. You want to make sure in your contract that you write up that it can go toward rate buy down. Just mention that in there, because a lot of times you'll put closing costs, prepaids, and that's it. Put closing costs, prepaids, interest rate buy down. That way it's all accounted for and you don't have to get a GA later. It's not necessarily required to say that, but just depends. Underwriter may want you to do that. Just get out of the way. Add that in there, no big deal. So this is how it works. The person has still locked in, the buyer is still locking in a 7.125. On their closing documents, it will say 7.125, and it will show the full payment as if it was year three and beyond, okay? Because that's what they're qualified for, and that's what the payment is. But on a 2-1 buy down, the $5,661.96 is spread out. And the amount that is contributed to each individual payment is the equivalent to someone having a 6.125 in the first year and, a 5.125 in the first year and a 6.125 in the second year. So, for example, on this one, now this is principal and interest only. The first year, the total payment due on principal and interest is $1,627.33. The seller's portion of the monthly payment, because we're going to take that and put it into escrow, is going to be $312.15, making their payment $1,315.18. That's for the first 12 payments. Same thing is going to happen the next year after payment 12, payment 13 comes in. The monthly payment due for principal and interest is $1,627.33. But with the 2-1 buy down, $159.68 has been allotted from the seller's credit for those next 12 months. So their actual payment that they're paying is $1,467.65. Obviously, when that runs out, month 24, the total monthly payment due on the principal and interest is still $1,627.33. There's nothing left from the seller, zero out, so hit their monthly payment, principal and interest is $1,627.33. A temporary buy down does not affect the actual interest rate that they are qualifying for, or that is locked in, or that is on their closing documents. It is just simply the seller paying a portion of their interest due each month for whatever buy down terms you have set up. Okay. 2-1 buy down is your most common. The same exact thing that I just explained would be the same on a 3-2-1 buy down. It would just be a larger number collected from the seller, and then a larger drop on that first year, second year adjust, first year adjust, and then after that, zero back out, regular payment that's on the CD. Once again, we're trying to do this to alleviate some pain. Rates are getting better. Sellers are willing to still do this. I mean, if rates today, which not that hard to get, somewhere in the sixes, if you do a 2-1 buy down, someone's easily in the fours, you know, at that point. So this could be a very good tool while we're in this little interim period where rates start to come down. Sellers are still offering a little bit of closing costs. So think about it. Watch this video again. If you need more explanation on it, reply to this email. Be happy to tell you more about it. Again, not super complex. You just have to make sure that you ask for the amount you're going to need to do the 2-1 buy down. You got to get that from the seller. And then as long as the person qualifies at the normal rate for that market rate for that loan, then you can do this. And obviously it saved this person from the description earlier. First year, it saved him $312 a month. Second year, it saved him $159 a month. If someone refinances before the 2-1 buy down has fully, you know, gone out, whatever money's left in there, let's say there's $1,000 left in there, they don't lose it. On a permanent buy down, it's gone. On a temporary buy down, that is basically in an escrow account. And when they close it out, they're going to get those funds. They'll usually apply it to the loan amount. Like when they refi, they'll lower the loan amount with the remaining funds. So hope that helps. If it helped anybody, give me a thumbs up or something on there. Shoot me a smiley face. Text me and tell me you love me. Anything like that. Thank you.